Hi, welcome to our brief stargazing guide series. This one is for August. In this month, the night sky is dominated by summer objects. We'll look at constellations, asterisms, and their corresponding stars. I will also talk about the visible planets. As usual, I will begin with objects bright enough to be seen from light-polluted areas, and then proceed to related objects. Therefore, this guide is meant to be useful in light-polluted skies for bright objects, as well as dark skies for the less visible details. The illustrations used in this guide are from the perspective of a person viewing from 50 degrees north of equator in August, around 11 p.m. to midnight. They have been obtained from Stellarium app, but can also be accessed through Stellarium web. I've picked the constellation Aquila as our main constellation for this month. Finding Aquila will take us through our favorite starting point for summer, the summer triangle asterism, where we will once again be able to see the constellation Cygnus. This month, at the reference place and time of this issue, the planet Saturn is joined by the planet Jupiter, becoming the dominant objects in the southeastern sky. In the northeastern to eastern sky, we'll find part of the constellation Andromeda and Pegasus, the winged horse. We'll also identify the great square of Pegasus asterism. In this area, we'll also visit the constellation Cassiopeia and the star Capella. In the western sky, we will see the last visible part of the spring triangle asterism, the red giant Arcturus. Here we will find the constellation Bootis and the asterism Big Dipper. Lastly, we will do a brief visit to the northern sky to see the pole star and the Ursa minor constellation. So let us begin with the southern sky, finding the constellation Aquila the Eagle. Looking south and raising your eyes up, you will easily see a very bright whitish star overhead on the right and another not so bright on the left. The one on the right is Vega and the one on the left, which we can connect with a line like this, is Deneb. Looking forward in the same direction, there is another bright star here, which we can use to make a triangle with lines running from Vega and Deneb like this. These lines complete the summer triangle asterism. The star at the end of this triangle is Altair. It is the brightest star in the constellation Aquila. The rest of stars in this constellation may be hard to see from light-polluted areas, but I will trace them, and if you are in a dark sky area, you can trace them with me. From Altair, in the direction of Vega, there is a star close by, which we can connect with a line like this. In the other direction is another faint star close by, which we can connect with a line like this. Again from Altair, in the down rightward direction, there is a star that we can connect with a line like this to form some kind of T shape. Extending the line we have just drawn further down with a little turn to the left, we can touch the next star like this. That completes the body of the eagle. Next, we need to draw the wings. From the star in the middle here, there is a star that we can connect with a line running in the right upward direction like this. And further out, there is an even dimmer star that we can connect like this. Finally, on the opposite side of the star in the middle, there is a star that we can connect like this. This completes the wings of the eagle, and therefore we have the complete shape of the constellation Aquila. Sometimes you will see this constellation looking like this. While we are still here, let us talk about the constellation Cygnus, this one. It begins with the star Deneb as its tail, and its body runs in the forward rightward direction, like this. The wings of the swan run from the star close to Deneb, like this. That completes the shape of Cygnus. You can hear more about Cygnus in my previous two videos. Now, let us turn to the planets, Saturn is down here, and Jupiter is the very bright object to the far left in the eastern lower sky. Planets were considered in the ancient times as wandering stars because they do not stay fixed relative to other objects in the sky. Today we know that they are our closest neighbors orbiting the Sun with us. I find it interesting to see how far apart Jupiter and Saturn have moved since October last year. Jupiter is closer to the Sun, and so it orbits faster than Saturn. So compared to where they were in my October 2021 video, Saturn does not seem to have moved much relative to the summer triangle, but Jupiter has made a big step. Next, we turn to the eastern and northeastern sky. First, if you face northeast and raise your eyes up, the W-shaped constellation of Cassiopeia is easy to spot. It looks like this. Looking further left in the downward direction, you'll find a bright star that dominates that part of sky. That star is Capella in the constellation Auriga. We can draw a line connecting Cassiopeia and Capella like this. On the right side of the line we have just drawn is a visibly bright star that we can connect with the lines from Cassiopeia and Capella to form a triangle like this. The star we have just touched is called Mirfak. It is the brightest star in the constellation Perseus, the hero. From Mirfak, in the rightward direction, are several bright stars that we can connect with lines like this. The first three are part of the constellation Andromeda, which looks like this. Above this shape here is Andromeda Galaxy. Andromeda is our closest galactic neighbor, situated about 2.5 million light years away. It can be seen with naked eyes, but you need a dark, clear sky and good sight. The rest of the stars in the lines that we drew belong to the constellation Pegasus, the winged horse. In this position, the horse is upside down with its body here, the front legs here, and the neck and head here. If we take away the head and legs of the horse like this, we remain with the great square of Pegasus asterism. Turning to the western sky, the red giant Arcturus that has been with us since April is about to set. Arcturus is the brightest star in the constellation Bootis, the kite, which at the reference place and time of this video runs in the upward direction like this. Bootis neighbors the Big Dipper asterism, which is clearly visible in the northwestern sky up here. As we have seen in the previous videos, the star Arcturus can be pointed from the handle of the Big Dipper by extending it with an arc line like this. To end our tour, let's visit the northern sky. Looking straight north, the Big Dipper is up to your left here. To find the pole star, we extend a line upwards from the stars at the right end of the Big Dipper like this, until it hits the next bright star. If we have done it right, the star we have hit here is the Pole Star, also known as the North Star. The constellation Ursa Minor, also referred to as the Little Dipper asterism, runs in the leftward direction of the Pole Star like this. To the right of the pole star, you can see Cassiopeia up here and Capella down here. We talked about this when we are looking east. That brings us to the end of our brief tour of the night sky in August. I hope you have enjoyed it. If so, please like. I will also appreciate your comments. Thank you for watching.